What's up, what's up, what's up, everybody? This is Jamar Rashawn. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode. Sorry for the wait. Let's get straight to it. Today's future athlete is Deshaun Watson, a.k.a. Michael Jordan, according to Dabo Swinney. And in the 7 games that he started before his ACL injury on November 8th, he was playing lights-out football with a 103.0 quarterback rating and 21 touchdowns in 7 games. Without further ado, Deshaun Watson. The Jaguars are in a tight cover one in the red zone. The play call is a zone read, play action, crack and go. He's reading number 50, Telvin Smith. If he steps up, he just throws it right behind him. Easy completion for the touchdown to D-Hop. 50-yard scramble for the touchdown against the Cincinnati Bengals. He does a good job of staying patient in the pocket, but he steps up. And now he's just making a play, man. I'm not going to overanalyze it, but I think this was the moment that the NFL knew that he was for real. Watson connects with Ryan Griffin on a 9 pattern. He does a great job of ball placement because he sees McCourty's outside leverage, so he just throws the ball on his inside shoulder for the touchdown. The Patriots have one high safety, cover one. The play call is a split zone play action seam. As you can see, he's reading McCourty. McCourty is leaning towards D-Hop. He's a little bit too late, and it's a touchdown right up the hashes. Excuse me, right in between the hashes. To Ellington, here's the back view of it. He does a great job of just putting the ball right in between the defenders. The Texans send Ellington in motion to see if it's man-to-man, which it is. All it is just a pick route, aka a dummy route. Lamar Miller is going to slip out to the backside. Everybody else is going to flow the opposite way. And as you can see, nobody covers him for the easy touchdown. This is the Texans' bread and butter right here. Just a halfback dive, play action, slant on the backside. He's reading the safety, which in this case is Bird. As you can see, Bird eyes is in the backfield. That is a sin. That is a sin. That is a sin. And as you can see, he don't even know where D-Hop is. Easy touchdown. The Titans are in a cover three. I don't know how they scored this. Play action, unbalanced formation, over route. Fuller just gets behind, lack of communication, easy touchdown. He sends Griffin in motion to see if it's man-to-man. The Titans overcommitted, so he just cut it back upside the A-gap, easy touchdown. Cover zero, which means he has to get the ball out quick because there's pressure coming on the backside. Fuller does a good job of running a pile-on route. It's just a simple smash concept. He throws the ball only where he can get it. Play-action pass, like I said, this is their bread and butter. Backside slant. They're reading the safety. Let's see what Parker does. He looked at him. Quick glance. Just beats him. First read was to D-Hop, who ran the slant. Terrence Mitchell covered him pretty good. He comes outside of the pocket, looks at Fuller, who runs a pigtail. Peters gets caught looking in the backfield, and he gives up another touchdown. Texans offense is not complex at all. They run the same play, just from different formations. They send Griffin in motion to see if it's man-to-man with the reverse off of it. All it is just a deep crosser two-man route. Mitchell just can't locate the ball at the right time. Easy touchdown for Fuller. At this point, I knew the Texans had everything going for them. All it is just a Hail Mary. Watson is good and patient in the pocket. He just throws the ball up, and D-Hop just wanted the ball more over Terrence Mitchell. Watson does a great job of ball placement on the back shoulder fade. Terrence Mitchell reached at the line of scrimmage, so D-Hop had to teach him a lesson for the touchdown. So the Texans love to do the deep crossing route, so this is their counter when most people catch on to it. Peppers, he didn't do a good job because he tried to cheat the deep crossing route. Jamar Taylor did a terrible job. He is in a trap technique in the boundary, and he has no immediate threat, so he has to keep sinking. Here's the back view. It's the play action, sucks up the linebackers, leaves the middle of the field open. This is a damn good ball placement, and that is the view that I was talking about. This is their bread and butter, the split zone play action backside slant. He's reading the safeties. This is a layup to Hop. Seahawks run their cover one a little bit different. Sometimes they give help to Sherman, but most of the time they don't. So Earl Thomas in this case is going to stay flat-footed. He's trying to bait Watson into throwing the deep crosser right there. He's trying to bait him to throw that, but he has to get his eyes back to number one. He is a hair too late, and that's 4.27, 4.3 speed. That's touchdown all day. Even the vets get forward every now and then. The Texans run the same plays, just different formations. But Watson is the person that makes this whole engine go. As you can see, all it is just an over banana route by Fuller. Sherman gets caught slipping. Here's the back view of it. It's just a sexy formation. They kind of got this from Clemson, you know, trying to make Deshaun Watson feel like he's at home. And that was just a hell of a ball placement by Watson, only placing it where his wide receiver can get it. Now, this is the same concept, the same exact concept, just in a shorter distance. The only difference is Lamar Miller is going to slip out of the backfield. Ellison comes in motion, same exact concept. He fakes it, he breaks the tackle, he steps up. Easy completion for the touchdown. The back view shows it a lot better. The Seahawks actually had the perfect play call. Everybody was in their right gap. The only difference is Lamar Miller, he's unaccounted for because of the play action, and he slips right out for the touchdown. Watson does a good job of getting the ball out of his hands quick and identifying the pressure, and the rest is history. Hopkins does the rest to the 50, to the 45, to the 40, to the 35, to the 30, to the 25, to the 20, to the 50. Damn, I messed up. I knew I wasn't going to say it right, but y'all get what I'm saying, man. This guy's a stud. He's going to be a star. I'm going to do my best to not put too much pressure on him because we all seen what happened to RG3. But I think this guy could be special. It's unfortunate that his season had to end in week 8. Let's just hope he can bounce back. And I'm excited to see what Watson and the Texans are going to do in the near future.